one and all. This is a global message, because as you will appreciate it, the Lord has invested in me, leadership here in Miracle, and across the globe, just to give you some form of assurance that fear is never faith. I told you before, and I'm telling you again, that the Bible said, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. It is paramount, partners, friends, even my unsaved friends today, that you know your God. And just to be assured that if you know him as he wants you to know him, you have nothing to fear but fear itself. In Daniel 11, we read, those who do know their God shall be strong and do exploit. In the fasting we had January, 40 days fasting, I called leadership in the church and I told them, this was long, long before I heard anything of this virus hitting planet Earth, that God said there are things that we must do. 2 Chronicles 7:13, he said, if we send locusts, if we send pestilence, if we send famine on the land. But notice, in verse 14, he said, if my people who are called by my name would do four things. One is, humble themselves, number one. Don't beat yourself up and question what you've done wrong, what you've done right. Just humble yourself in the sight of God. Then he said, the next one is to pray. God loves us when we pray to him in humility. Not that we are his boss, but he is our father. So you come, like the prodigal son came home to his father, the spirit of humility, daddy. The father didn't even allow him to go through all of what he wanted to say. Daddy said, enough, son. Embraced him, kissed him, put his robe on him, and his ring on his fingers. What a joy. All daddy wanted is my son come home. All the Almighty God is looking for us to do is to come to him in humility. Then the next step, he said, whatever you do, seek my face. Seek his face. Please, I know it's a time of anxiety at home, and sometimes the television or the radio or the telephone calls, and you're depending on someone to remember you. But it's an opportunity for us as saints to seek the face of the Lord. Spend that little time, put on your Christian tape, if you haven't got a tape, and you have a Christian station on your radio, television, and it must be a godly one, because even now, some people will use this as an advantage, over you. And it's because you've done this and because you've done that. No, God said, just come, just turn, whatever you have done, he is God, and he will bless you. And the next thing he said here, if we turn, amen, just turn turn from our old ways. People have been ringing me up and asking me, Pastor, is this God or man doing this? But I have one question, one answer for the loved ones. This is my spirit to just remind you, nothing taken God on earth by surprise. God knows what he's doing. I commend you who are standing up in faith to stand strong. Seek his face and he will bless you. You remember quickly in the time of Jonah, how that when he went into Nineveh, the people repented. And that's all God is expecting us to do. Turn to him. And you'll also call to mind that as you come to God in faith, believing in Romans 10, he said, it is with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and it is with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. If you confess your faith today in the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. Don't beat yourself up on your past. Today you have a chance to put things right with God. And if you have, and confess him with your mouth, just tell somebody that you have turned your life over to Jesus and you can go in faith that it is well. God will watch over you. Don't worry about life here or life beyond. What matters to all of us is that wherever we are in Christ Jesus, we are saved. We are secure from all alarm. I am pleased to say that by the grace of God, I am 83, well, I'll be 83 in July, and God is still keeping me. I believe with all my heart that he's not partial. He will do the same for you. Put a smile on your face. Faith in your heart. Don't listen to some of these weak, backboneless things that you're hearing that, what, and where is God now? God is right there beside you, and he will see you through. God bless you. You have good courage, and he will strengthen your heart. In Jesus' name. Amen. From the Exodus, as you will rightly remember, Jesus Christ told Moses what to do. He told the officers, and the officers the people, that they should kill the lamb, daub the blood on the lintel of the doorpost, because I'm going to pass over Egypt. It's imperative to know this. In Exodus 12, right there in your home, your living room, where you may be, that you will join with us in the scriptures. So as you take on Exodus 12, you will find God's command. He commanded them to daub the blood on the lintel of the doorpost. There's something about the blood. He said, death angels will be passing through Egypt. And the sign they will be looking for is the blood. He said, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. Now back into John 6, Jesus has given us instruction. And there he told us straight the importance of the communion and the blood. What he has given to us, we must take it with meaning. Jesus Christ came after all that Exodus story that you would read, and he's given us instruction. He fed 5,000 men beside women and children. But when he came for the communion, it was with his disciples. That's how important it is. And you will find this in St. John 6, when he said, I am the bread of life. Jesus Christ said, he is the bread of life. Next he said, and this is important, your father did eat manna in the wilderness, and they are dead. This is the bread which cometh down from heaven, that a man may eat thereof and live. I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If a man eat of this bread, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh, which I will give for this world, or for the life of the world. Now, you can read that scripture, you will also notice there what he says, his blood is real drink indeed. So as we begin today to appreciate what they had inherited us and what they are enjoying now, you will see that there is power in the blood of Jesus Christ. He said, my blood is drink indeed. Read John chapter 6. So right now where you are, let us just appreciate the presence of the Lord as if you were with us in the congregation. Let us pray. Father God Almighty, King of the universe, we thank you that 2,000 years have passed, and what they experienced then in the Exodus, what the disciples experienced when Jesus Christ was with them in human form, we are experiencing it today. But the blood of Jesus Christ is just as strong and real today as then. And the disciples could not understand it because they thought, how could we eat your flesh and drink your blood? But Jesus said, if a man eateth not my flesh and does not drink my blood, he has no life in him. And with this life, I believe with all my heart, Father, that there is no evil that can befall us. For this, for some of us, you have given, hallelujah, as a reality, and we take it to mean then what it is. Even now in the time of Christ, it is better, I believe, we need the blood of Jesus. Glory to God now. So Father, where your people are right across the globe, amen, as miracles stretch, oh, from one end to the next, and they're joining with us, I just pray in the name of Jesus that we will have testimony out of this communion service of deliverance, healing, and blessings. Thanks for being so real to us, God Almighty, in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 God bless you, friends, partners, saints, as we're going to be reading to you the instruction, the revelation Paul had about this communion. Stay with us and be blessed right where you are. Amen.
This reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, reading from verse 23 to the end. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup, when he had supped, saying, this cup is a new testament in my blood. This do ye, as oft as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Wherefore, my brethren, when ye come together to eat, tarry one for another. And if any man hunger, let him eat at home, that he come not to come together unto condemnation, and the rest will I set in order when I come. Thanks be to God.
Yes, you have heard the word of the Lord. So today, in the love of Christ and with the love of Christ in your life, you will understand this is imperative that you know, that Jesus Christ is alive. The body of Christ that he went to heaven with, but on earth today, the body of Jesus Christ is his church, you and me. So don't be afraid. There is no evil that can touch the body of Jesus Christ. So although we are not together physically, but spiritually, I just feel, I can see that smile coming from your face, lovely, beautiful smile, that you love Jesus and Jesus loves you. As you heard, you have taken the body and blood of the cross, of Christ, simply because you know that you know, that you know what it means to you. God will bless you. I want to assure you that this day, as we serve you, the body of Jesus Christ and his blood, you may not even be feeling 100%, but I can guarantee you this day that you will experience a miracle where you are. I have seen it happen in my own life over the years, the past 60 years. Yesterday, the 2nd of April, I celebrated 60 years of ministry and being in the church. And I have used this communion as my medicine. Right now, I can proudly say to you, he has kept his word. He will not fail you where you are today. God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you. The Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, will you please pray with me? Just as you are, where you are now, just bow your head and focus on the living bread, the bread of life. He came down for our salvation. He came for the old man, the man's spirit, his soul, and his body. Father, in Jesus' name, I hold this bread in my hand, and I bless it in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. According to your word, Father, I believe that this is exactly what you commanded us to do. And as your people over the world right now, join in with us wherever they are in this communion. And as a reminder, hallelujah, how you were broken for us. Their faith will be lifted right now in claiming, if they are sick, they are healing. If they are weak, their strength. If they are poor, their riches. I bless this bread. Now, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. And said, this is the body of the Lord, which is broken, hallelujah, for you. This do ye as oft as ye eat it in remembrance of me. Eat ye all of it. Body of the Lord which is broken for you. The body of the Lord which is broken for you. Body of the Lord which is broken for you. This do ye as oft as ye eat it in remembrance of me. As you join with us where you are now, in your own way, whatever you have in your hand as your bread, remember, he who is still working miracle,
amen,
is turning this around. So just believe with me that as we pray here, you are blessed where you are with this. So hold up that you have in your hand, representing the body of Christ. And hear this. Jesus said, this is my body, hallelujah, which is broken for you. This do ye as oft as you eat it, in remembrance of me. Eat ye all of it. God bless you. Praise God. Give him a praise.
Hallelujah.
Give him a praise.
Hallelujah.
Give him a praise.
Hallelujah.
The love of God.
Hallelujah.
It's right where you are. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You see, the enemy's plan is to close us down.
Hallelujah.
But this is going to be the busiest time and the greatest establishment,
yes,
for the church of the living God.
Hallelujah.
So give the Lord another praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And amen. And amen. And amen. In St. John 6, verse 53, Jesus said, for my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. It's important to follow us as we pray for you today. Amen. After the same manner, also Jesus took the cup. Amen. I trust that where you are, you may not have what we have in this cup. But even right now, even if it's a drop of water, orange juice, whatever you have in your cup, Jesus Christ can change it into what he wants it to be. But this we are taking, and I want you to understand this, that whatever is in the cup that you have, or the glass you have in your hand, he will turn the water into wine, hallelujah, has power to turn it into his blood. So right now, Father, in Jesus' name, you said, unless we drink your blood, we have no life in us. Well, we believe today that you could turn the water into wine.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You could change us who are lost,
yes,
sinners. Our religious belief could not help us. And I know that if you could save a sinner like me, then surely you can turn whatever I have in this cup today into the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
And we take it and believe it, that it will do us good in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And you say where you are with me, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. This is the blood of the Lord that was shed for you. This do as often as you take and drink it in remembrance of me. Drink ye, beloved, all of it. Amen. Amen. The blood of the Lord, it reaches to the highest mountain. Hallelujah. And it flows to the lowest valley.
Yes, hallelujah.
It's the blood that gives me strength. From day unto day, it shall never lose its power. It's the blood. It's the blood. It's the blood. It's the blood. Hallelujah. It's the blood. It's the blood. It's the blood. It's the blood. You will remember I said in Exodus 12, oh, if death angels come in the land, so long as they see the blood, the sign of the blood, on the lintel of the doorpost, they would not have any death in the family. I decree and declare that this virus that is going around will not bring death and destruction to your family. In the name of Jesus, I want you to believe with me. In Jesus' name, the blood of Jesus prevails. Amen. 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 Thank you, and God bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. I hope today you have really enjoyed the presence of the Lord, communion, but please don't run off. Bow with me, so you may be in your living room, at home, or wherever you are now, and just relax for a moment. It's the blood that gives me strength from day to day. It shall never, friends, lose its power. Watch this, it reaches to the highest mountain and it flows to the lowest valley. It's the blood. It's the blood. Oh, hallelujah. It's the blood. It's the blood. It's the blood. It's the blood of Jesus. It's the blood of Jesus. Those of you who have been redeemed through the blood of Jesus today, don't be afraid. Say it with me right where you are. It's the blood of Jesus. Say the blood of Jesus. 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 Oh, the blood of Jesus. You will notice as you say the blood of Jesus, there's a difference in the atmosphere, because Satan is not afraid of coronavirus. He's not afraid of cancer. He's not afraid of any disease, amen, humanly speaking. But he's afraid of the blood of Jesus. So may God bless us today. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Amen.
Help me to pray.
break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain, yeah. To break every chain, 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 yeah.
I will trust in you, Lord.
From the book of Jude, verses 24 and 25. This is when you can all join in with me and say it with authority. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless for the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. And all say with me,
Amen.